क्या आप या आपके परिवार में कोई डायबिटिक है? जानिए भारत के प्रसिद्ध डायबिटीज स्पेशलिस्ट से कि डायबिटीज को कैसे करें मैनेज, सीधे अहमदाबाद से, जहां देश विदेश के 5000 डायबिटीज एक्सपर्ट्स एकत्रित हुए हैं। डायबिटियोलॉजिस्ट डॉक्टर्स की एनुअल कॉन्फ्रेंस RSSDI में 22 से 25 नवंबर 2018 तक। लॉग इन करें फेसबुक पेज डायबिटीज पर चर्चा पे।
अ पब्लिक अवेयरनेस इनिशिएटिव बाय इप्का लेबोरेटरीज लिमिटेड।
वी हैव डॉक्टर एसके शर्मा ऑन डायबिटीज पर चर्चा फ्रॉम RSSDI अहमदाबाद। Welcome, Dr. Sharma.
Thank you.
Dr. Sharma is a renowned endocrinologist from Jaipur with more than 20 years of experience. He has his clinic, Galaxy Speciality Center on Ajmer Road, which is diabetes, thyroid and endocrine center. Yes, Doctor, you had given talk on during RSSDI on GLP-1 receptor agonists non-glycemic benefits.
Yes.
So if you can just give us in brief about your topic so that it would be beneficial for those who could not attend RSSDI at Ahmedabad.
So, dear friends, topic was GLP-1 receptor agonist non-glycemic benefits. So, we started with what is GLP-1 receptor agonist. As we all know, GLP-1 is a hormone which is released from L cell of intestine, and this goes to pancreas. In beta cell, it increases insulin. In alpha cell, it inhibits glucagon and thereby improves the glucose profile of our patient. But in addition to these effects, there are many non-glycemic effects of GLP-1. But GLP-1 is rapidly destroyed by DPP-4 enzyme. So with modification in its, structure, adding some chains like fatty acids, you now make a long GLP-1 analog, which is not rapidly destroyed by DPP-4 enzyme. And because of this, you are giving these analogs either once a day, or even now we are having GLP-1 receptor agonists which are given once a week. But these are protein products, so they have to be given injectably. With this background, if you look into the non-glycemic effect of GLP-1 receptor agonist, we found that these drugs are causing significant weight reduction. So in different trials with different GLP-1 receptor agonists, like Amigo trial, Duration trial, and lead trial, there was a weight reduction of something like 2.5 to 5 kg. With liraglutide, 3 milligram subcutaneous once a day, even 8.5 kilo weight reduction was documented. And because of this, now liraglutide 3 milligram is available by the name of Scandiva from USA. And this drug is used for weight reduction, even in non-diabetic patients. So this liraglutide 3 milligram is now considered to be a weight reducing drug. In addition to, as we know, we are using liraglutide 1.8 milligram per day as an anti-diabetic drug. So one is weight reduction, the other is cardiovascular benefits. So all these cardiovascular outcome trials which are there, we know that these are outcome trials are showing the cardiovascular benefit of GLP-1 against a placebo. So studies like LEADER with liraglutide, study like Duration trial with exenatide long acting, and study like with dulaglutide Trulicity, we have seen that there are significant reduction in MACE, that is major adverse cardiac output, cardiac outcome. So like cardiovascular death, stroke, and non-fatal myocardial infarction. So something like 13% reduction in this MACE was seen in LEADER trial, and similarly 26% reduction is seen in trial with semaglutide. So that is sustained 6 trial. So indicating that these drugs are cardiovascular friendly, they reduce inflammation, they take care of cardiac, metabolism, they improve the vessel health, they have endothelial improvement, all those things with addition to reducing, markers of inflammation, like decreasing brain natriuretic polypeptide, reducing hsCRP, reducing PAI1, all those things are indicating that they are cardiovascular safe. With additional point is that there are some evidence of renal safety. So decrease in proteinuria by these drugs were also seen. Their gradual fall of estimated GFR is reduced when the patients are on GLP-1 receptor agonist. Similarly, there are few studies which are looking into their effects on bone, and they have some positive bone aspects. Similarly, they have cytoprotection in the form of, let's say, neuroprotection in Alzheimer's disease, and in many other studies they have looked into the effect of these drugs, and they identified that they improve the neurological function of neuronal cells. So these are some, you can say, pleiotropic effect of these GLP-1 receptor agonists. In addition to an effective drug, now we have drugs which are reducing cardiovascular morbidity and mortality. Renal profile is improved, and then additional points, like they also reduce blood pressure. So these things are making these drugs very favorable. The only point is these drugs are to be given injectably, and these drugs are costlier drugs. So, and if you look into the latest ESD and ADA guideline, you find that after metformin and lifestyle modification, the first line of drugs are, if the patient is having existing atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, then you have to give GLP-1 receptor agonist. If he is having renal impairment and estimated GFR is, let's say, above 30, then you can give GLP-1 receptor agonist also. So these drugs are significantly showing better improvement. Weight reduction is there, so now they prefer in patients who are obese or patients where you want to reduce weight, these drugs are again preferred. These are the salient features of GLP-1 receptor agonist. Thank you.
Thank you, doctor, for coming on Diabetes Par Charcha and the giving us information on non-glycemic benefits of GLP receptor agonist. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.